definitely going to be one of those Battle of the Minds kind of things, just on the way that they both play. They played long enough to where they both know what it is that they're trying to get away with, and it's going to be a game on who's going to get away with it harder, or who's going to get away with it first. And no, it's Onberry. He's looking really good, man. But it's going to be a lot of fun. So I would say get ready and hold on to your hats. Dax is holding on to his hats. Are they trying to start Smashville, or is Xander not happening? Immortal not happening, any of that? Yo, Timko, you and me, I think, are playing on stream next.
You need Danville on?
Yeah. But, you want to commentate with me about Pittsburgh Classic? You don't want to commentate the Pittsburgh Classic?
I'm commentating this game. I don't like this game.
Alright, that's fine. So right off the bat, you just kind of can see that Zax is very content in just floating around and doing all this stuff. And while Xander is gonna be sprinting around looking for these openings, he got one right there. That's the start of something. But it's gonna be on Zax's court in order to avoid these kind of setups that Zach is trying to get him into. Like, see, right there is the very good example of the kind of style that Immortal likes to play, and that's an up smash, and that is a very, very early first stock, especially on Battlefield. It's gonna be on Zach's now to be able to pull this one from behind. It's gonna also be on Immortal in order to be able to hold on to this one. You can kind of see, Zax is definitely one of those kind of players that is very content, and if you're going to let him sit there and charge Shadow Ball, he will sit there and charge Shadow Ball with a smile on his face. But that was a good power shield by Immortal to be able to avoid both the shield damage and the pressure. But you can kind of see that Immortal's now just kind of running away with this. Just right there, this was a single mistake by Zax, and Immortal has now gotten, like, at the very least 40% off of it. Very curious as to what brought them to Battlefield. It might be because of the fact that Zax has the platforms, but that's dead. Man, that was a minute and a half game. It definitely does not take that long. It definitely does not that short of a game whenever these two are playing. So it's honestly really surprising. But that was game one. We still have potentially another two games to play. Zax is definitely known to be able to make the adjustments, but it's very much so. The ball is definitely in Zax's court right now. The ball is definitely in Zax's court. If he doesn't get the chance to play ball at all, that'll be pretty disappointing. So now we're now on FD, and this is a stage that both Immortal and Zax really love. Zax is very famous for being able to get away with murder on this stage, while Immortal is also just famously known to be very good on FD in general. That was a really nice break trip with the Shadow Ball there. Didn't get him too much, but it was enough. You can see right here. I mean, sometimes whenever you see Zax just doing this, just kind of playing this game where he's just kind of sitting around and waiting for you to do something, and, well, doing something to get you hit, it's very easy to feel intimidated or even discouraged by this, but then again, this is Bowser, and he got a single grab and got almost 50 off of it, and that was a back air, and he's dead. Man, that is pretty nasty. The Shadow Ball could have got a more there, but right now it looks like they're just kind of, originally they were, it just kind of looked like they were trying to feel each other out, but now it's like, one person's already stocked down, and Bowser with, oh my goodness, that's it. Wow. That. Man. Folks, I'm at a loss for words. I am ludicrously surprised that this went this fast as it did. But, alright. Well, that's a 2-0 for Immortal. Holy cow. Well,